Happy New Year, everyone! Firstly, I want to say thank you for subscribing to my channel since my last two videos. Your comments have been really encouraging and I'm just really happy to hear that you guys are enjoying the tutorial. Today, I'm really excited to be sharing with you and continuing our 3D Hacks for Beginner, where we'll turn these 2D characters into 3D characters, all in Adobe Illustrator. And the other good news is that you won't need to be able to illustrate because I'll be showing you how I source the vector illustration that I use in this video. So let's go! First, let's go to designstripe.com. Designstripe is a smart design tool. It has several unique creative features like their huge catalog of illustration that you can customize right in the browser, and they have one style library called Cheerful, linked down below, which is 100% free. Beautiful designs and load of scenes and objects to choose from. This is the illustration catalog and we'll be using this scene here. Let's click customize and we are in the web editor. You can decrease the details in the scenes and even adjust the style of the illustration itself by dragging this part here. We will use this level for this tutorial. Let's hide the background objects because we will only need the character. You can also generate random color palette to choose from. Or, if you need to, you can manually change certain color code like the hair and the skin here. Feel free to follow along. Once done, click download. And under the SVG format, you can copy SVG and you can paste it on any design software like Figma or Adobe Illustrator like we are doing today. Let's paste our illustration in Adobe Illustrator. I have also arranged my canvas, so I'm separating the background from the character. And this is the hex codes that I'm using in our tutorial today. The next thing that I'm going to do is that I'm going to delete the shadows because when we turn them to 3D, they will naturally have shadows. I will now start grouping some elements. Firstly, select both the fringe and the face and press Command G. Next, the ear and the line on the top of the ear. I'm also grouping the hair at the back together. I'll also be selecting all the body parts and group them together. And lastly, for the facial features, select them and group them and then just copy and drag them to the side. Click Windows, select 3D and Materials. Let's put the panel on the side. Select our elements and click Inflate icon here. Alright, now we're going to do a repeated adjustment to the elements. Click the first element, select the material tab. At the bottom there are settings for the roughness and metallic. Click on each element and then change them to 0.65 for roughness and 0.13 for metallic. Just repeat this for all the different elements that you have grouped earlier. For the facial feature, let's click on them. Click the graphics tab and click on this plus icon on the right side here. Select, add a single graphic, drag this away. Let's click on the face and then we click the graphic we added and it will project the facial features onto the head. We can also adjust the position. Now, we will move on to lighting. Similarly, just follow the settings that I have on screen. Feel free to pause anytime to get all the numbers. Some elements will have different settings to get best result. I will adjust the color of the light, intensity, rotation, height, softness, and ambient intensity. For the body, since it is lots of element, don't worry if it's taking a while to render and load. I have put the screenshot of the final settings on the screen for you to enter as well. Once done, we will start rendering these elements. Click on each element and click on the render icon of the top right of the 3D panel. Do this for all the elements. And we're done! You have made a 3D character without having to illustrate anything or use any 3D software. You can experiment with other characters or explore other objects in designstripe and turn them into 3D. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and please write down comment below on what you want me to do next. Bye!